Hello, guys. This is Paul McQuarter with TopTechBoy.com, and we're here today with episode number 58. In our incredible new tutorial series where you are unleashing the power of your Raspberry Pi Pico W. What I will need you to do is pour yourself a nice tall glass of ice-cold coffee. That would be straight-up black coffee poured over ice. No sugar, no sweeteners, none needed. And as you're pouring your coffee, as always, I want to give a shout out to our friends over at SunFounder. SunFounder is actually sponsoring this most excellent series of video lessons. And in this class, we will be using the Kepler kit for Raspberry Pi Pico W. Now, most of you guys probably already have your gear, but if you don't, look down in the description. There is a link over to Amazon, and you can hop on over there and pick your kit up. And believe me, your life and my life are going to be a whole lot easier if we are working on identical hardware. But enough of this shameless self-promotion. Let's just jump right in and talk about what I am going to teach you today. And what I'm going to teach you is I'm going to show you my solution to the homework assignment that I gave you in lesson number 57. But I must first ask, how many of you were successful? If you were successful, leave a comment down below. I am legend. Double chest bump. And if you were not successful, leave a comment down below. I folded up like a cheap Walmart lawn chair. Hopefully most of you guys got this because it's really sort of a follow-on to a lot of the things that I've been teaching in the earlier lessons. Sort of it's like reinforcing the learning that we had in the earlier lesson. So hopefully a lot of you guys got it. But let's jump in and talk about what the assignment was. I will get out of your way. We'll have a sip of coffee. And let's hop over here to our live overview of the setup that we have. And what your homework assignment was to take the joystick and connect it to the Raspberry Pi Pico W and to report the angular position of the joystick. So if we move all the way to the right, the sort of positive x-axis is 0 degrees, and then angles are measured counterclockwise from the x-axis, and so this would be 0. This would want to report 90, over to the left 180, all the way down 270, and back to the right, that would be 360, or back to 0. And so we want to know what angle you are holding the joystick at. Now, I should probably just give a quick recap of how we had this thing hooked up. Hopefully you guys already have yours hooked up, but if you look with the pins pointing to the left, you have ground, 5 volts, VRX, and VRY. Those are the pins. And the way that we have this thing hooked up is we have the ground pin connected to physical pin 38. We have the pin that's labeled 5 volts. We have it hooked to 3.3 volts because we have a 3.3 volt A to D converter. And that is physical pin 36. So we have physical pin 38, physical pin 36. We have the VRX connected to GPIO pin 27, and we have the VRY pin connected to GPIO pin 26. So that is how we hooked it up. Now, in lesson 57, I showed you how to get a calibrated reading for X and Y from your joystick, where to the right would be the point positive 100 for X, minus 100 for X, up is positive 100 for Y, and down is minus 100 for Y. And so rather than develop that code again, let's go out and just snag that code that we had at the end of lesson number 57. And you can do that by coming over here to the most excellent www.toptechboy.com. You can come on over here to this happy little search icon. You can search on something like calibrating a joystick in MicroPython. you'll come to this lesson, and then you can run out and grab this code by clicking on the little two-page icons. And then we can come over and we can go to Thani and we can paste that in. And based on the connections that I just showed you, let me look here. Based on the connections that I just showed you and this code, we should be back to where we're getting calibrated X and Y values from the joystick. So let's just try that and see if it works. See if the universe is in proper working order, and boom. In the neutral position, we're getting 0, 0. That's good. If I come to the full right position, I'm getting 100 and 0. Full up is 0, 100. Full left is -100, 0. Down is 0, -100. And so everything seems to be working properly, that we're getting calibrated X and Y values off of the joystick. Now what we want to do is we want to turn that into not an X and a Y value, but we want to turn that into an angle. Okay, so how do we do that? Hopefully you guys figured this out, because we did a couple of lessons earlier on some simple trigonometry, and hopefully you saw that that's what you need to apply. And so I'm going to come in here, and normally when you think about getting an angle, you think about having a vector that you're spinning around forming a circle. But we don't have a circle here. Really, we've got kind of a square. So we've got to sort of figure out how we're going to do it with a square. So always, what would I tell my math students? Anytime you have a math problem, step one is don't panic. Okay, step one is don't panic. We got a square versus a circle. Don't panic. Step two is draw a picture. Step three is label a picture. And then step four is write the equation. So where are we now? Step one, don't panic. Take a deep breath. Take a sip of coffee. We're now where? Step two. What do? We draw a picture. Okay, so I'm going to come up here and I'm going to draw a picture that sort of represents. That's not good. Let's try again. Okay, try again. Okay, give me just a second here. Okay, so I'm going to draw a picture, and what I'm going to draw is I'm going to draw a square like this. Okay, and this, that's not right. Try again. That is beautiful. Okay. And that is the square that is mapped out by the joystick. All right. Now I'm going to try to add kind of a coordinate axis to it to make it a little easier to think about the math. And so I'm going to have an x-axis that I'm going to try to draw. I have an x-axis, and then I'm going to have a y-axis like this. Okay, and now I'll try to make it look a little bit more like an axis. So that's my positive x, minus y, positive y. Okay, now if the joystick is all the way to the right, what was my reading? This point was X is 100 and Y is 0. What is this point? Minus 100 and 0. There's no Y value. I'm just going back and forth. Now on the Y values, this was X is 0, Y positive 100. This would be X is 0, and this would be minus 100. You see, we can sort of map out these various locations. How about if we came up here to the upper right corner? Well, that I'm reading an X value of 100 and a Y value of 100. Let's try one more. I could come up here like this, and this is an X value of minus 100. And a Y value of 100. And then what you've just got to see is you've got all the points in between. You've got all the points in between that you could map out this square. Now, what is it that we actually want? What we actually want is we actually want this angle. Well, to get this angle, we need trigonometry. right? We need trigonometry. And what you got to see is we've got the x value, we've got the y value. What is that angle? Remember, angle is equal to the tangent inverse of y over x. Okay, what is the y value? Well, if I'm looking at this point, the y value is this, and the x value is this. So this is y and this is x. What is really good news? What am I getting from the joystick already? I am getting y and I'm getting x. I've already got that. And remember, what did we call those last week? We called them the h-val, which is y, the horizontal value is y, and the v-val, the h-val is x, and the v-val is y. So I've got y, I've got x, and therefore, what can I calculate? I can calculate the angle, theta. Now, how would I do this in MicroPython? Well, I would just give it, I could give it theta is equal to, how do I do tan inverse? Well, it is math dot a tan, which means arctan, which means tan inverse, a tan of y divided by x. And so I could put that in MicroPython right now, and I could get the angle. Now, what is the problem? Well, the problem is if I'm up here at this point right here, what is going to be happening? Y is 100 and x is 0. And what would I do? I would be dividing by 0. What happens when we divide by 0? Airplanes crash. Buildings fall over. Bridges collapse. You cannot divide by zero, because if you divide by zero in math, you get an error. But when in engineering, you apply that to a real problem, you can have actually disasters happen. And so we want to make sure that we're not dividing by zero. Well, one way you could do that, you could say, well, if x is going to be 0, I'll just make x 1, and that way I'll get an answer. I won't get 90 degrees, but I might get 89.99, and that would be good enough. So that's one way you could do it. Another way you could do it is MicroPython kind of solved the problem for you, that if you use theta is equal to math dot a tan 2, In that case, rather than the way they have you do it is instead of saying y divided by x, you just give it the y comma x like that. And then it takes care of those special cases for you where the program might crash. And so you can either do it this way and you do adjustments where you're never dividing by zero, or we can just take advantage of the work that MicroPython did for us, if that makes sense. Okay, so that sort of shows what the problem is. Let's jump in and let's see if we can start coding. Okay, I will come back over here to, I'll come back over here to this view. And then we've already gotten the code from toptechboy.com. Okay, so now what are we ready to do? We're ready to take the y and the x value. The x value is h calibrated and the y value is v calibrated. And now we're ready to try to get an angle. Okay, and so what I'll do is I'll come here and I'm looking at that equation we just wrote, and I see that degree, I'll just call theta degree. Degree is equal to math dot a tan, and we did already import math up here, so we're okay. So degree is equal to math dot a tan 2, because we want to take advantage of that checking for the special cases. And what is y? Y is v cal, okay, v cal like that, comma h cal, All right. And now I should have a degree. Could it really be that simple? Let's see. I will need everyone to hold their breath. And then I want to come down here and I want to print degree to see what we get. Hold your breath. Good news is it didn't crash. And so let's come over here to the positive X and we would like to see 0 degrees and we got 0 degrees. That's great. I'm going to come up straight up and I would like to see what? I would like to see 90 degrees, but I'm seeing 1.6. What's going on? If I come to the left position, I would like to see 180 degrees, but I'm seeing what? 3.14? That sounds a lot like what? That sounds a lot like pi. And if I go straight up, I'm getting like 1.6. That sounds a lot like pi over 2. Somebody tell me what's happening. Leave a comment down below. What is happening? Houston, we have a problem. What is the problem? The problem is, which we should know by now, but every time we do it, we sort of forget it usually. The arctan2 function reports the angle in radians. It reports the angle in radians. And we as human beings usually think in degrees. And what do we need to do? We need to convert radians to degrees. And so how would we do that? Well, I could come in and I could say that the degree, I'm going to come up with a new degree is equal to, well, in radians, you got to think of it as what fraction of the circle have you gone around? How many radians in a circle? 2 pi. So what fraction have you gone? Well, you go degree and then divide it by 2 divided by math.pi, okay, like that. And then that should tell us the fraction of the circle that we have gone around. So let's just try running that and see what happens. What? Math.pi, math.pi, how about that? That should give us pi. Okay, good news is it didn't crash. If I come to the right, I'm 0% of the way around the circle. If I go straight up, I'm 0.25% of the way around the circle. If I go to the left, I'm 0.5, halfway around the circle. You see, I'm halfway around the circle. Okay, so that part works. So that's the fraction of the circle. Now we multiply by how many degrees in a circle, 360. And so now if I multiply by 360, I have converted radians to degrees. So let's see if that works. All right. We go like that. I come to the right. I'm at 0. Let's see. Yeah, I'm at 0. Straight up, I am at 90. That's good. The upper right is 45. That's good. The upper left is 135. That's right. And the left, if I go full left, I'm at 180. Hey, that's great. Now let's go straight down. If I go straight down, I would expect what? I would expect 270, but I am getting minus 90. Okay, I'm getting minus 90. Now this is to see. You see, I think of a circle. When I think of a circle, I want to go from 0 to 360. But what this MicroPython arctan2 function is, it reports things as either 0 to 180 or 0 to minus 180. So it reports from 180 to from minus 180 to 180. But we can compensate for that. But I want you to think about it. You see, like if I go all the way around, I'm thinking in terms of 270, but arctan2 reports what? Minus 90, because it thought, well, you started here and you ended here, you went minus 90 degrees, and I'm arguing, no, I went positive 270 degrees, but they're exactly at the same point, so it doesn't matter. You've just got to kind of normalize it in your head. I want it to go from 0 to 360, and the way I can fix that is I can just say, well, if degrees being reported is less than 0, what do I want to do? I want to go all the way around again to kind of get arctan2 acting the way I think. And so then I would say if degrees is less than 0, I'm just going to say degrees is equal to degrees plus 360. Okay. And if you think about that, And I haven't run the program yet, but if you think I'm all the way to the left and a little bit further, I'm getting minus 179, where I really want 181, which would mean add 360. So think about that. Pause the video if it doesn't make sense and sort of convince yourself that's true. But now let's watch. So I'm going to start at 0. I go to 90. I go to 180. And now straight down is 270. And then it comes on up back to what? Back to 360 or 0. Okay, so now this thing is behaving like I want, right? It is giving me the angular position from 0 degrees all the way around to 360 degrees. Boom. Now I have that. Okay, so that was pretty straightforward. Hopefully you guys had as easy of a time with it as I did. This is reinforcing things that we learned in earlier lessons. Okay, now what is the homework assignment? The homework assignment now is for you to get your little servo out of the SunFounder kit, hook the servo up to your circuit, and then control the position of the servo from the joystick. So if I put the joystick at an angle of 0, the servo should point to 0. If I put the joystick at 90, the servo should point where? To 90. If I put the joystick at 180, the servo should point at 180. So as I'm sitting here playing with the joystick, the servo is tracking it. Now the servo can't go 360, so you only have it working between 0 and 180, but you're controlling the position of the servo from the joystick. Okay guys, hopefully that will be straightforward, because in earlier lessons I showed you how to get the joystick working, so you're just kind of getting different things that you've already learned, putting them together into a nice program. Okay, guys, I hope you're having as much fun taking these classes as I am making them. As always, I want to give a shout out to you guys who are helping me out over at Patreon. You guys that are standing with me on Patreon, you're the ones that keep this great content coming. Thank you. You can also help me out by giving me a thumbs up in the video below. Leaving a comment down below will help me with the YouTube juice. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, subscribe, and when you do, ring that bell so you'll get notifications when future lessons are dropped. And most importantly, share this video with other people, because the world needs more people doing coding and fewer people sitting around watching silly cat videos. Paul McWhorter with toptechboy.com. I will talk to you guys later.